welcome back ringside live and exclusive from the Royal Albert Hall. Gary, what a tremendous first fight that was.
That was a classic fight and a classic performance by Johnny Armour. Johnny Armour, he comes from the St Mary's Amateur Boxing Club in Chatham, and they train all their fighters like that. And I think everybody in Chatham and everybody from the St Mary's can raise their glasses because they've created a champion.
There were times during the fight you were saying to me, he should step it up a little bit more.
Yeah.
Now, this is the end of the fight. There were times when he should have done what he did here.
Yes, Johnny in the last round, he just kept his man under constant pressure, whereas in some of the earlier rounds, he didn't keep the pressure up, but this time, he knew it was the last round, he had nothing to lose, he just went great guns, and to the end, his man went. And it was worse than that because we saw, well, you couldn't see on the camera, but he couldn't sit down for a very long time, could he? Because his legs wouldn't
his legs
move, would they?
Completely gone. Right to stop
yeah.
it. So after only 8 fights, he's a Commonwealth champion. What can he go?
Well, he's only got upwards to go. At least John can start earning money now and start like being a champion. He's like, it's been a bit hard for him. 6 grand in a year, that's not enough to keep anyone going. But now he's reaping the rewards and good luck to Johnny.
Well, wish him all the best. Anyway, before the big fight, we had a competition last week in which the prize was 2 tickets to this evening's contest. I asked you to send in your top 3 votes for the 10 knockouts that I showed you on last week's programme. So, in reverse order, here are the 3 knockouts that ended up the most popular. Voted Walcott v. Charles as your favourite knockout. Unfortunately, there was only one winner, and it was Mr. Hennessy from Bow, East London. He's out there tonight somewhere enjoying his prize. Well, not much longer to go now. Let's have a final look at the 2 men who, in just about 5 minutes' time, will take to that ring just behind me in the fight they're calling All or Nothing. Lewis is the favourite, and both he and his camp feel it's just a matter of time before we see him reaching the ultimate goal, the world heavyweight crown.
Lennox Lewis, champ. That says it all. Everywhere you go and everyone you speak to seem to echo those few choice words. Such is the camp's confidence. The preparation has been done, the training is over, and now is the time. A faultless record for Lennox Lewis, 26 years of age, 19 fights, 19 wins, 16 by knockout, no losses. In sparring, Lennox has looked devastating. His speed, movement and punching power are impressive. It's a long way on from the raw novice of the past couple of years. Lennox was a little ragged then, always keen to win, but big haymakers and wild lashing punches prevailed. That's not so today. Those rough edges are smooth now, and his disposal of Tyrrell Biggs was testament to that.
The right hand through from Lennox Lewis. Desperate moments here for Tyrrell Biggs. Lewis is looking to finish it. Uppercut right. Biggs is all over. That is it. Finish. 3rd round. Lennox Lewis does the job 5 rounds quicker than Riddick Bowe did that. And that was very impressive indeed.
His new trainer, Pepe Correa, has been a big influence in the past month or so since his arrival. Lewis has become the genuine article. Sparring partners have fallen by the wayside.
I'm telling you right now, and I say it now, and I have no qualms in saying what I'm about to say. Lennox Lewis whips anyone in the top 10 right now. And the only reason he won't kick Holyfield's ass is because he duck us. Your Riddick Bowes, your Holyfield, bring him on. He beats all those guys. This man is the next heavyweight champion in the world.
No one in the camp doubts Pepe's words. Lewis is the first to praise him.
He's been a very big influence. He's just showed me a different look, a different outlook. You know, there's not too much I can learn within this space of time. but you may see flashes of the old Lennox and the new combined.
The new Lennox impresses everyone, even his mum, Violet. She's there as always with her encouragement. Manager Frank Maloney sums up the fight like this.
With Lennox, it depends on what mood he's in. I think he's a bit upset that Derek didn't attend the final press conference, so that might make him come out. He may want to show some of the new boxing skills that he's been working on with Pepe in his training team. On the night, if the openers are there, I think it'll end very quickly in Lennox's favour.
But what of Williams? What does he bring to the dance? He's tall, he's strong, and he's more than capable of delivering an upset. Lennox will not take him lightly. This is Williams' record, 27 years of age, 23 fights, 19 wins, 14 knockouts and 4 losses. But he's never been stopped. He says his training has gone well, and the old magician Angelo Dundee has helped enormously with his preparations.
I just brought out, be honest with you, what's there. By that I mean the training's been specifically what to do to lick Lennox Lewis. I physically got him ready because naturally there's a right way and a wrong way to physically get ready for a fight. I showed him what to do, how to run, little innate things about preparing, breaking the sweat before you do anything, those kind of things.
Just how much has Angelo taught him? We all know he's capable, but is he confident? The Williams camp have been behind closed doors in an attempt to shun the publicity machine and the pressure.
We realise that we're going to have a lot of pressure from the press and the public about Lewis being great. And, you know, they're trying to dampen my spirit or, like, get under my skin and prevent me from training properly. So I went away to America and trained with Angelo, and I think that's been a wonder in itself. Just me, just seeing Angelo has done something for me.
But has it done enough? Williams is a huge underdog, but will this dog have its day?
I mean, I'm born and bred in Britain, you know, but I've been pushed out aside like an outcast, you know, but I'll rectify that on Thursday night.
So, all the predictions have been made, all the hype's finished with, the big fight after the break. Don't go away. Talk about this fight. The betting has been incredible. The odds have changed tremendously over the past couple of days. Look at the odds now. Where's your money going?
My money would go on a late stoppage by Lennox Lewis, so the odds of 20 to 1 round 9, 10, 11 and maybe 12. Well, 9, 10, 11 and 12 are quite good.
Up to a couple of days ago, you could have got 33 to 1 on Lewis and not Williams out in the first round.
Well, I've got a bookmaker friend, Ivor Thomas, and I told him to slash his odds.
One of the things that's interesting is this man, Angelo Dundee. There's his list of champions. Now, he is in Williams' corner. Will he add anything to Williams?
He's coming for one fight, and I don't think one fight is going to change Derek Williams that much.
Tremendous record from Dundee, but, well, I don't think he's been with him long enough. Let's look at the tail of the tape, the two boxers. This is crunch time. This is what it's all about. There you go. 6 foot 4, not a lot in difference height, not a lot in difference weight. What do you take from that?
Well, the reach is actually important because that means Lennox, Derek Williams is going to be facing someone that can actually hit him. He doesn't get that opportunity quite that often. The only thing that Lennox Lewis has to worry about in this fight is Derek Williams' power. He is actually a lot more powerful than his record suggests. And maybe for this fight, he will try for once in his life. And if Derek Williams does try, Lennox Lewis is in for a lot of hard work.
Right, well, this is it. Crunch time. We'll see now. No more ado. The hype's done with. Let's go straight to ringside to your commentators, Glenn McCrory and Ian Dark.
Well, should be some fight this for the British, European and Commonwealth Heavyweight Championships is Derek Sweet D. Williams, as he likes to call himself, capable of causing the big upset. An awful lot of plans are going to go out of the window for Lennox Lewis if he does. And Angelo Dundee, the new trainer for Derek Williams, insisting that his man can do it. And of course, Angelo Dundee, as Gary's been telling you, has pulled off a few tricks on his time. And here's Derek Williams on his way to the ring now. Of course, the big question mark against Derek Williams in the past has been, he's competent, but has he got the flair, the inspiration to be a winner at top level?
I think that's right. It's how much confidence he's going to have on in this fight. He's got the size, we know he's got the power, but he's got lots of attributes. But does he have the want, the need, the hunger to pull this one off? And to do that, he's going to have them things. He's really going to have to win. He's got to go all out to win. And
And it's just whether, you know, whether he wants it that much, whether can Angelo Dundee instill that in him. I think that's got to come from his heart.
And there is Derek Williams. You can see his face has been bathed in sweat. He'll have been doing a bit of working out in the dressing room, as fighters like to do, don't want to come in cold. You can see the sweat beads there. He looks a shade on the apprehensive side, or is that just a normal expression?
It's very hard to tell. I mean, he doesn't look full of confidence and bigger, but it's hard. You know, it's all boiled up in your mind. These are very difficult moments when you're going into the ring of a big fight like this.
And there he is. All the paraphernalia. Natty dressing gown. But of course, once all that is stripped off, it's simply a question of whether he's good enough. A chat to referee Larry O'Connell there, who's one of Britain's best, and we await the entrance now of Lennox Lewis. Williams, the Commonwealth champion, he's held that for 4 years, he's only had to defend it once, and here comes Lewis now. Pepe Correa going through the picture there. Ornate settings of the Royal Albert Hall in the background, and look at Lennox Lewis there. He always seems so cool, detached and icy, and we hate to keep reminding Glenn McCrory about it, but it was in this very same ring, this very same arena. You faced Lennox Lewis at first hand. How good is he, do you think, Glenn?
Well, I mean, I can't say anything, but he is very good. He's very, very strong. That's one of the points that you don't really expect from him. You expect the good boxing, you expect the classy moves, but you don't really expect the strength of the man. Very big, very strong. He's got an amazingly long left jab. And these are all things that, you know, Williams has got to be prepared for. He's done it. He's done it right. He's got the best guys. He's went out to the States. He's had the best barn. So really, it's down to him and how much he wants it.
Lennox Lewis, who sacked his trainer John Davenport, and now has Pepe Correa, who was in the Sugar Ray Leonard corner, as indeed was Angelo Dundee. So two transatlantic based trainers in opposition here. An unusual aspect of the fight. Look at Lewis, he always has that kind of casual way with him. He has tremendous self-belief. Who else would go on to a TV chat show on the eve of the fight?
Well, he certainly does. He has a good temperament, an awful lot of confidence. He's jumped in the ring and taunted Derek Williams right from the beginning. But Williams doesn't seem deterred. He's there. He's having to go. It's eyeball to eyeball stuff.
He too has been working out in the dressing room. By the way, Lennox Lewis, 16 stone 6 and a half, and Derek Williams at 16 stone 9. We'll get the ring announcements any moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please be on standing for the national anthem? Championship. Introducing in the blue corner, wearing the white trunks, from Peckham, the heavyweight champion of the Commonwealth, today at the Odeon Haymarket. Lewis scales 16 stone 6.5 pounds, Williams 16 stone 9 pounds, 12 3-minute rounds.
So referee Larry O'Connell calls them together for their final instructions. So much at stake here. Lennox Lewis, his people are talking about a world heavyweight title shot at this time next year. There will not be one if he loses here. And Derek Williams, so many doubts about him. If he can beat Lennox Lewis, become the first man to do so, well, he really will have gate-crashed his way straight in to the world top 10. Williams will need some performance here on all known past form. Away they go, Lennox Lewis in the black trunks. Nearly 33 stone of muscle in there. Lewis is very dangerous with his jab. Finds his way in with Adam Williams, already under a bit of pressure in this opening round. Although he's never been stopped or knocked out, Derek Williams. And then a little warning from referee Larry O'Connell to keep the punches up in the opening seconds.
I think that the warning there, when Lewis used the open of his glove and pushed Williams' head right up back over the rope. I think that's one of the things Williams has got to watch out for. And Lennox, you know, looks very good, but at times can be a little bit dirty.
Angelo Dundee, Derek Williams' new trainer, famous man of course, has been saying in the build-up to this fight, makes no secret of it, he thinks from the videos he's seen that Lennox Lewis can be not a dirty fighter, he said, but he does throw illegal blows and does illegal things. Well, a lot of the top heavyweights have done that. Mike Tyson was hardly Mr. Clean, was he? Lennox Lewis with that good jab of his again, and his defense is pretty handy too. He gets the gloves up well, but his last performance, he looked a little bit lethargic, a bit jaded against Levi Billups, and will want to establish himself back in the minds of the British public, particularly with Frank Bruno right back on the scene as well these days.
Well, Williams is getting his shots off. He's already landed with a couple of jabs and a right hand. It's going to be interesting to see if Lennox can get past the size of Derek Williams. He's very big, very tall, long arms himself.
Williams getting in with a decent right uppercut there. Holding his own fairly well in this opening round, Williams. He's pretty adept at spoiling and mauling when he has to and buying a bit of time. Lewis under a bit of pressure. We've never seen Lennox Lewis under real pressure, and his performance here will be assessed against the likes of what people like Evander Holyfield and Reddick Bowe would have done.
When Lewis is walking in, he just looks like he's looking for a big shot. He's walking in and he's allowing Williams to catch him one of two shots, and he can't afford to do that. He can't have that sort of contempt for Williams. He's got to, you know, he's got to do his work properly.
Oh, let's go with the right hand there, Lewis. Oh, and he clubs him with another right. Heavy career shouting out at Lennox Lewis from the corner, use the jab. Interesting opening round. Williams didn't do too badly at all there, Graham.
Williams did okay. He certainly did. He got a few shots off. Lewis seemed to just walk forward, not really throwing shots.
There's Lennox Lewis's record. 19 straight wins, 16 have come inside the distance so far. Lennox Claudius Lewis, to give him his full name. Derek Williams in the other corner. Well, he's lost four, and two of those were unbelievably bad performances against the aging European champion at the time, Jean Chanet. In fact, he lost the European title, Williams, to Chanet, and failed to regain it, claiming he was doped in the first fight. And then there was a crowd riot in the second. It was a very unhappy period in Williams' career, and frankly, he hasn't really recovered from it yet, but he might do tonight if he can come up with the goods here. Angelo Dundee in the corner, the man whose book is called I Only Talk Winning. Second round. Black Trunks Lewis, Williams in white.
I think Lewis has been told in the corner to assert himself a little bit more. He's come out and he's starting to use the jab a little bit and trying to throw a few more shots. He did very little in the first round and allowed Williams to you know, tee off on a few ordinary looking shots.
How ambitious will Williams be here, we wonder. He's making Lewis miss quite a bit and he's making him look quite jaded there. Lewis just patting Williams's head there playfully, and Williams returning the gesture. Short of confidence, Williams, in these opening two rounds. He doesn't look fazed by Lennox Lewis's reputation, does he?
He doesn't, but again, that may be, you know, nerves coming out in him by doing them sort of things. It's very hard to tell. It's very hard to tell whether, you know, he doesn't think Williams can hurt him, or whether he's very, very nervous and he's trying to, you know, make Lewis think he can't hurt him.
A lot of mauling and spoiling at close range, and Williams frustrating Lewis, denying him the space to get off with any kind of combinations that he might have in mind. And each little right uppercut inside scored by Williams there.
Well, Lewis isn't getting any boxing going. You know, he's barely landed with the jab. He's basically just walking in, looking as if he's going to try and bomb Williams out with a big shot.
Yes, you've got the feeling that Lewis would look better if he started working in behind that jab. He has a one-inch reach advantage, 82 inches, Lewis's reach, although Williams is slightly, just slightly, the taller man. That's decent right from Lewis.
I think this is the sort of fight that Derek Williams will want. He'll want to start, you know, messing Lennox Lewis up a little bit, you know, let them have a tug with each other for the, you know, see who's the strongest, try and wear Lewis out a little bit. You know, this sort of fight will suit Williams a little bit.
That's better
stuff. He's got to get that jab going.
Sharper jab, doubled up on it, and looked much better when he was doing that, Lewis.
That's the only way he's going to find the opening. You know, he's got to start using his jab, you know, doing different sort of different shots. You know, make Williams throw something and then catch him with a good counter punch. You know, work for his openings rather than just expecting him to come.
And a lot of big talk about Lennox Lewis, about the possibility of him being Britain's first world heavyweight champion this century. He has to go out and prove every time. It's a lot of pressure that he's in that kind of league to justify that talk. Welcome back to the Royal Albert Hall. You're watching live the British, European and Commonwealth heavyweight title fight between Lennox Lewis and Derek Williams. Two rounds gone. Lewis, frankly, has looked a bit sluggish so far, Glenn.
He certainly hasn't impressed, and I think Williams has shared the first two rounds. Lewis has looked too much to try and get big shots on, and it's been very messy and a little bit mauly. I think Lewis needs to get his jab going, as he's trying to do there, and throw a few more shots.
Remember, Williams, nobody's managed to stop him or knock him out so far, so he does have a record of durability. Lewis trying to find the openings again, being made to miss with the right hand. He looks as if he's been given a bit of a rollicking in the corner, Lewis, between the rounds. He's come out looking to go fast, doubling up on his jab. Around the waist, Williams.
He does. He's a very big man. He's carrying a little bit there, but, you know, he's very tall. He's got a lot of weight on him, so it doesn't look too bad. I'm sure he will have trained very hard for this fight.
Derek Derek Williams feels that he's had a bad press and he's been rubbished too much, and he was glad to go to Florida, he says, to do his preparation with Angelo Dundee. And I was talking to Angelo last night, and he said that Williams had fitted in well and worked very, very hard for this fight. He tips Williams to win it, but I guess you'd say, well, he would, wouldn't he?
Williams is, you can see, he's trying to mess him about. He's talking to Lewis in the clinches there. He's trying to get him spoiled, and he's trying to, you know, upset his game plan. At the minute, I think he's having a little bit of success with that. Williams, Lewis isn't getting his shots off. He's walking forward, taking a few.
That's a good right hand, though, and that did hurt Williams. Now he wants to hold on. He was shaken by that right from Lewis, all right. And he's having to hold on for dear life at the moment. That was Lewis's best shot so far.
They were good shots, but he's so big, Derek Williams, so big and so strong, he can wrap Lewis up a bit.
Williams' head seems to have cleared. But Lewis knows now that he can hurt him, and he's got through again. It was lucky for Williams that the following left him find his target. That typical Lennox Lewis punch, that angled, chopping right hand, almost seems to come from over his head, just missing its target. Oh, what a right uppercut, and another one, and a right, and down Williams goes. That was impressive. Is he going to get up from that? 7, 8, 9, it's close, it's stopped, it's over. And Lennox Lewis, after two rather sluggish looking rounds, gets the job done in the third round. Not quite clear whether it was a count out or a knockout, but it didn't really much matter. Larry O'Connell deciding that Williams was in no fit state to continue. No arguments here about that. And the finish, whatever you say about the rest of it, was pure class from Lennox Lewis.
Yeah, when he hurt Williams, he did the job. He caught him with a big overhand right hand. That hurt him. And then he stayed on top of him. And he threw them big shots. And Williams just didn't do anything to get out of trouble.
First time that Derek Williams has ever been stopped or knocked out. He's got the words champ there, you see. Derek Williams, kind of shaved into the back of his head. Well, unfortunately, he's no longer a champ, because Lennox Lewis now holds not only the British and European titles, but the Commonwealth as well. Now, have a look at this finish again, because this, I think, is where Lennox Lewis shows his world class. He can put these punches together in clusters. Take a look at this.
It's a good right uppercut there, and he threw the shots together, and he's hurt him. Williams was hurt before that, and he just kept the pressure on with big clubbing shots.
He's done what nobody else has done before. Those were three quality shots. The right uppercut that started it was a real humdinger from Lennox Lewis, and nothing wrong with this win at all. We'll get the ring announcements any moment now, and we'll try to grab a word with Lennox Lewis as well. Here it is again, Glenn.
Good right uppercut and the left uppercut, and then the right hand just finished the job off.
And 30 seconds it took him, and Lennox Lewis takes his record to 20 wins, no defeats. He's ranked in the top four by all the world governing bodies, and any animosity there might have been beforehand, and frankly there wasn't too much, I'm happy to say, little word from Williams to say well done. And when he went down, he saw Williams give Lewis a very old-fashioned look indeed. And Glenn, looking at that, what do you think about Lennox Lewis? Let's put you on the spot. Is he good enough to be world heavyweight champion?
I think he's good enough to be there or thereabouts. He's certainly good enough to challenge for it. Whether he wins it is down to him. He was a little bit sluggish in the early part of this fight, which he couldn't afford to do with Holyfield. But when he did it, he did the job.
Lewis issuing a challenge to Frank Bruno there from the ring microphone. Well, after this, the demand for that fight is going to become a clamour, and the money would be very big. It could happen.
Well, Lennox is baying for Bruno. The crowd are baying for Bruno. Gary and I are baying for Bruno. We'll talk about it after the break. Don't go away. Welcome back to the Royal Albert Hall. If you went down the pub and you just come in, you've missed it. If you want to see the Italian football, the Italian Cup, second leg, Sampdoria Parma, it follows this programme. Gary, just sum it up for me.
Well, I am very impressed by that performance from Lennox Lewis. I didn't think Lennox Lewis would be able to stop Derek Williams inside maybe six or seven rounds. So that is a very good performance. And that has echoed the warning that Lennox Lewis has issued to Frank Bruno. Frank Bruno in three rounds. The crowd are shouting for Frank Bruno. Lennox Lewis is shouting for Frank Bruno. And Lennox Lewis has everything that Frank Bruno needs.
Well, we need that fight. The public want the fight. Lennox wants the fight. I mean, it's got to happen.
Yeah. Well, this will be one of those fights that by public demand.
Well, this is how he finished it. I mean,
you're talking about a man that's never hit the floor before. He was decked in three rounds. That has to be an impressive performance by Lennox Lewis. Well, it certainly has impressed me.
It's a beautiful right uppercut. I mean, he was gone.
Another uppercut. The two uppercuts done him. Derek Williams is a very capable fighter. He's normally a good survivor. He holds, he mauls, and he has a fairly good punch himself, but for this today he wasn't able to do anything. And what you have to remember is there was three titles at stake. This wasn't just an international 10-round fight. There were three major titles at stake, and when there were titles at stake, people put their lives on the line.
Looked to me the way that Williams came out, that he was going to sort of try and make it go the distance.
Well, Williams came out in the first round and he tried, and the second round he started to hold and more, but I think Lewis got to him. I don't know where Lewis has found that power from, because that's impressive power. I didn't know Lennox Lewis had power like that.
Well, he's always threatened it. He's always threatened it in previous fights. I mean, he knocked Biggs down three times. I mean,
yes, he had, but that I thought he was capable of doing. And recently he said that he'd knocked Frank out in three rounds. Well, now I'm beginning to think that he might be able to do it.
It goes along with what we've said so many times before, is that a big man is made for him. The Billups fight, I mean, he got criticised. That's a shorter guy.
Yeah, the shorter guys that can duck under Lennox Lewis's
exactly.
Randy punches always give him trouble. But anybody that stands upright and sticks their head up in the air gives Lennox Lewis a very good target, and he can actually look better.
Now, they've spoken about Ruddock. That, to me, seems a strange match after this.
Well, the Ruddock match is a very, very good match. If Lennox Lewis does fight Razor Ruddock, he will actually be forced into a number one contender position, and Evander Holyfield will then have to fight him. But it's a very, very risky match. It's a match that I don't think any heavyweight in the top 10 would really want to take at this particular time.
I don't think he needs it. Bring on Bruno, that's what we say. We'll have the interview with Lennox after the break. Don't go away.
Maybe some kill, Bruno.
Welcome back to the Royal Albert Hall live, Sky Sports. Great atmosphere, still buzzing. I wonder how they're feeling down in the dressing room. Paul Dempsey is down there with Lennox Lewis.
I don't think there was much need to towel you down, Lennox. How's it feeling?
It feels good. You know, I wanted to go in there and establish my jab, but Derek Williams wasn't cooperating.
You were exchanging a few words with him in the first round. What was all that about? There was even a smile from Williams.
Well, he said, you can punch harder than that, so I told him, okay, wait and see.
And that's what happened. You did. You opened up. But seriously, it seemed to me like the first round you were just warming up and taking him for size, and it was easy, wasn't it?
It was. I wanted to show a lot what Pepe showed me in the gym, but he said just go walk to him and just knock him out because he doesn't deserve to be in the ring with me.
So three titles now. Here's the Lonsdale belt, the first time that you've been the owner of a proud owner of a Lonsdale belt. But Lennox, it's the world picture we want to know about. Britain, maybe, Bruno, maybe not, but the world picture. Where next?
Definitely. Like I said, I'm just saving all my talent for the world champion, that's Evander Holyfield. Right now I'm knocking at the door and I'm waiting for him to answer it, and he's still ducking me.
What about Frank Bruno? Frank was probably watching that tonight, and there's a certain gentleman there who fancies you.
Well, if he fancies me, he knows where I am. You know, all he has to do is say he wants me and I'm here.
What are you going to do now?
I'm just going to go on holiday and just relax for a little while.
And Lennox, when will we see you in the ring again?
Hopefully sometime soon.
Come on, be more specific. You know where you're going.
Probably the end of July.
You never lost for a plan.
End of July sometime in America against, hopefully, somebody like Holyfield.
Okay, and for the British fans, finally, you've had your problems in winning them over, but maybe you feel that this is the night when you will finally win the majority of them over.
Definitely, I'm the man that's going for the championship. I've set all my goals that I wanted to set in Britain, and now I'm going for the World Championship.
And do you want those British fans to support you?
Definitely, I want the whole country behind me.
Have a good one in America. Maybe you will be the world champion, we hope so, for your sake. And it's always a pleasure to talk to you.
Thank you.
It is a pleasure to talk to him. What would you do? I mean, we said Ruddock, we mentioned him. If we avoid him, they don't really need to put him in with anyone big, do they? He's there.
Yeah, but you're talking about a man there that's brimming with confidence. He doesn't care who he faces. There you have a genuine champion and a genuine contender for a world title. It doesn't matter who they put in front of him, he will take them out. There are other fighters out there who are very fussy about who they fight because they're not sure of themselves. There's a man that's 100% sure, and he's just reinforced his confidence again tonight.
Well, confident is the word. We think he'll go all the way. Another person we think will go all the way is a young man from Sheffield who goes by the name of Johnny Nelson. Now, he fights live on Sky Sports, Saturday the 16th of May, 8:30. Don't miss that one either. Say goodbye to you, big fella. We'll see you in a couple of weeks' time. Thanks for being with us.
And Frank, all the viewers from Sky and all the letters I've been getting from people saying, we hope you're watching and we want to see you in Lennox if you want to be the best.
We'll see what happens. Plenty more big boxing on Sky. Don't forget Ringside Theatre on Monday. Ringside's back next Thursday, usual time. We'll see you. Great night's entertainment. Thanks for being with us. Goodbye from the Royal Albert Hall.